from Nicreative Productions, and today we want to talk about best little 150 euro lines and if it's worth the price. Hope you guys enjoyed. So earlier I was looking for wide-angle lines which I can use on a C-Cam E2, but I never really pulled the trigger for one. In the wide park, I stumbled over this 150 euro lines from Sound Artisans. It's a 7.5mm 2.8 version. For 150 euro, I didn't find what I was about that, and I gave it a shot. I thought it would be great for anybody who's done a backshot and who's looking for wide angle lens. So I wanted to see if the footage is any good. First of all, this lens is meant for micro four frames and aps-c sensors. So it's perfect for the C-Cam E2, for a 2x5, and for a Sony S6000 series. Secondly, the build quality of this little lens is amazing. It's made out of aluminium and it feels very solid. The weight is actually a little bit heavy for a small lens, but it's not too bad. The only thing which bothers me a little bit is the protective material on the inside of the lens. It does off very easily, but yeah, I can live with that, so that's right for me. A very important point to mention is that the lens is fully manual, so it means that there is absolutely no connection to your camera. So, for anybody who is just relying on autofocus, this will be a huge challenge ahead, and this lens is definitely not for you. For myself, I don't use autofocus at all, so this is not a problem for me, and I can totally live with that. The linear focus distance of the lens is 0.12 meters, so you can film objects which are really close to you. Maybe you can use that to get really close shots of these colors. The first one got a lot of distortion, but you can see the lens stuff really close. You can just try it out quick step. We also have a full aperture here, which means that there are no hard stops for each aperture value. You can get very precise with this, but you also have to be aware that you might unintentionally touch the ring and change your aperture value. Most of the time is to get away with this, but it's good if you keep that in mind so you can avoid it. The minimum aperture of the lens is 2.8, which means you can get some decent shots in limited scenarios. If this lens is not really a wide angle lens, actually it's a filter lens, the glass in front of the lens is curved. The next step on the side is the electromagnetic lens, so you get a little bit less protection there. Just if the curved glass of the lens, you should be aware that this can cause some heavy light flares. Depends if you like that look or not, this can be a downside. But if you like me, and you like those lens flares, it will be not a problem for you. In this design, this affects all of the lenses, it's not just this one. It's okay that I want to use some really small images, and I'm actually amazed by how well this lens performs. I use this lens most of the times for action sport and also scenarios where you want wide field of view. But as a successor, you have to be aware that you get a little bit of distortion on the edges. But for filming skis, snowboard, skateboard, all this stuff, I can wear this look if you have a little bit of a fisheye. So, it's not a hazard for me, and yeah, I actually prefer it for this stuff. There's a way for the only way I can get rid of the fisheye effect, so it's best when I see you, you can get rid of this. To see a little bit more how this lens will perform in different scenarios, I will now include some clips which I saw with the Sun Artisans and with my C-Cam E2. I'm trying to steal it. If I'm not ready, I'm just trying to try it. If it comes to you, I'm just